Listen here. The arrow diagram shows figure 1.10. This arrow diagram shows a relationship between the sets P and Q. It shows a relationship R. Write the relation in first subdivision set builder form. Next one is roster form. Next one is what is the domain and range of R. First you should know what is meant by relationship. You should know the definition, then only you will be able to write it in set builder form and roster form. So already we know that A and B are two non-empty sets. Isn't it? For Cartesian product also we have studied like this, isn't it? Let A and B be any two non-empty sets. Here P and Q. A relation R from A to B is a subset of A cross B. This is very, very important. Not only subset, satisfying some specified conditions. So they have said that it is a relation from P and Q. It is the relation between P and Q. So these two are non-empty sets. That is also it satisfies. Then some specific condition, under what condition it is related. You see the diagram 5, 3, 6, 4, 7, 5. 3 means what? It is less 5 minus 2. This is 3 is nothing but 5 minus 2. 4 is nothing but 6 minus 2. 5 is nothing but 7 minus 2, isn't it? So, in general, you have to represent, because set builder form is what we told you. Yes, it is a general form. You have to specify a variable. With the help of that variable, you have to build a set under some condition, under a rule. It should satisfy that rule. So, here, set builder form, how you have to write is R equal to. R equal to. It satisfies the condition. So, already we said that it is a subset of A cross B. What is A cross B? It is the Cartesian product. So, it should be in ordered pair. So, X comma Y such that. X comma Y such that. Here you see, if and only if X comma Y is an element of R. So, you know why we are writing here X comma Y. Actually in set what will we write? X belongs to natural number, like the type of the number. Then we will give, just for example I am writing. This is the condition, this is the type of the number. Like this we used to write. But here you have to write it in pairs. X comma Y is an element of R. Next, such that you have to give the condition. You have to give the condition. 5 belongs to P. That means this is X. This is what? Y. How are you getting this Y? X minus 2. So, images, how did you get this image? Y X minus 2. Y equal to X minus 2. In the place of X, just you substitute this value. 5 minus 2, 3. 6 minus 2, 4. 7 minus 2, 5. And also not only this, you have to write how X, then type of the X belongs to P, comma, Y belongs to Q. From where you are taking this element, that you have to specify. Do you follow? X comma Y such that Y equal to X minus 2. X is an element of P. Y is an element of Q. So, first subdivision is over. Next, second one. You have to write it in roster form. This is what set builder form. Set builder form. Next one is what? Roster form. Suppose those are unable to write in set builder form first, just you try to attend the problem correctly. Roster form, it is very, very easy. Only ordered pass. Even though you don't know all these rules also, you will be able to write the ordered pair. What is it? 5, 3, 6, 4, 7, 5. Every student, each student, you will be able to write this roster form and you can get a mark. You can get 1 mark or 2 mark, whatever it is. Isn't it? Roster form, it is very, very easy. After writing the writing this answer, you can write this set builder form also. No problem. Do you follow? Next one is what? What is the domain and range of R? Domain. How they have defined the domain. X is an element of A. Here X is an element of P. But what is the condition? X related to Y for some Y belongs to B. So there should be an image. So you should not think that all the elements what it is given in P, it is a domain. No. What they have given? X is related to Y. For some Y is an element of B. Here for some Y is an element of Q. Do you follow? Here what we you have to write? P related to Q. Do you follow? For some Y, X, X is related to Y, Y is an element of Q. Here X is an element of P, such that X related to Y for some Y. That's all. But this is not necessary. This is not necessary. Just you should follow. Why I said that many students, you are writing domain means all the elements you are writing. No. But in relation, it is something different. Do you follow? So, what is domain here? Domain of R. Why I am saying, you know, domain of R. Because there is a condition, X related to Y, for some Y, is an element of Q here. So, what is the domain? 5, 6, 7. Because 8 is not related here. 8 is not related here. So, you should not write 8. Otherwise, the first element of the ordered pair. First element of the ordered pair is the domain. Next, range. Range of R equal to the second element of the ordered pair. The images what it is formed. It is related, no? You see, the range of the relation is Y is an element of B. Here Y is an element of Q. X is related to Y. For some X is an element of P. Do you follow? Those who are brilliant children, you should know all these type of details. Then only when you are going for the higher classes, you will be able to answer for the objective type questions and also concept you will know. So without knowing the concept, please don't try to answer this type of questions. So that only I pasted all these things here. Do you follow? So the images, it is related. And also, it belongs to an element. After related only, the images, what it is formed, it will become a range. From order term, the first element is domain of R, the second element is the range of R. Do you follow?